For eons, people have stared at the stars wondering how they could reach them. Well, one day, curiosity got the better of them, and they decided to try. As people reached the stars, NASA learned something firsthand. Going to space was a one-way trip for the spacecraft. NASA decided to pursue a more efficient way to punch through the sky. So they embarked on a mission to engineer a reusable space shuttle. And the Columbia mission was born. But first, they needed a strong tire manufacturer capable of sticking the landing. So they called B.F. Goodrich. By the mid-70s, our engineers were hard at work figuring out this colossal task. Here's the thing about space shuttles. They're heavy. Really heavy. And the Columbia only had two sets of tires. A main landing gear set on the base, and a set of nose tires on the nose. Six tires landing 200,000 pounds at 200 miles per hour. Here are the four main landing gear tires. They were 183 pounds, tubeless, inflated with nitrogen to 327 psi, 44 and a half inches in diameter, wrapped in high-strength corded steel. They could handle 123,000 pounds of force each. The nose tires were 50 pounds, inflated to 312 psi, capable of handling 50,000 pounds of force each. Since nobody had gone to space and back in the same vehicle, we tested our tires on Earth. This 120-inch high-speed dynamometer simulated takeoff and landing at speeds of up to 400 miles per hour. And on April 12, 1981, 20 years after the first human spaceflight, the Columbia launched, piloted by Bob Crippen and John Young. After orbiting for 54 and a half hours and circling the Earth 36 times, they attempted re-entry. They had to maintain an angle of 40 degrees until they were through the harshest part of our atmosphere. The heat outside the craft was intense. The noise was unthinkable. But on April 14, after traveling over 1 million miles, the shuttle landed. Bob, John, and the Columbia made it home. The mission was a success. The world had a reusable shuttle, and our thirst for exploring new frontiers was revived the moment our tires safely met the Earth. B.F. Goodrich, what are you building for?